So, all right. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening sa ating mga kababayan. And this is Psei Recap. And today, we will be reviewing yung ating mga observance sa market. And, all right. So, I think for the last 2 weeks, we're on a dip drawdown. And I hope you were able to dodge, no? Yung mga market punches. All right. So, I think last week, if you will remember, I was not able to record. I was busy upgrading as well, yung mga systems. And even itong pinagre-record ko, this is a different software. I'm trying it out. Let me know kung may feedback kayo. But sa akin, medyo may static noises akong naririnig. And hopefully, we're not distracted. No? So again, I'm recording much earlier. Of course, there will be a... I think outside noises na talaga hindi naman natin makokontrol. And yung mga ibon pa, even aeroplano, no? I hope you're not get annoyed or distracted sa mga noises na yan. I think from what I believe, no, much more important yung time, no? Time is of the essence. And ayan, katulad yan, may dumadaan. And I hope you were not distracted, no? So, minsan kasi I was trying to pick out a time, mas tahimik yung lugar. But ang nangyayari, minsan nakakatulog pa ako even though I was already done with the recap. And I think, no, at this point in time, even yung market medyo magulo and very volatile, I think time is of the essence, no? And right now, no, we're going to review yung ating market and we're going to try to see kung ano yung mga observations natin. And again, maraming salamat sa panonood. And again, before we do anything, any analysis, no, I think this is a good reminder for all of us, no. This is from Genesis chapter 3, verse 19. By the sweat of your brow, you will eat your food until you return to the ground. Since from it you were taken, from dust you are, to dust you will return. Alright, so I think this is a good perspective, no, sa buhay natin. Of course, we all know scientifically, no, yung soil or even yung dust na sinasabi natin, most of the compositions na nandoon, no, nandito sa katawan natin, no, that's only goes to show yung accuracy ng Bible. Alright, so literally kung ano yung mga minerals na nandiyan diyan, nandito rin sa katawan natin, no, but of different proportion na lang. Alright, so I think ang mas mahalagang meaning dito besides the accuracy of the Bible is yung ating we're going to put everything into perspective, right? Diba? Alright, so I think none of us, no? I think majority, wala naman siguro magsasabi if, let's say for example, you have a terminal disease. Alright, wala naman siguro magsasabi na, teka lang, gusto ko pang magtrabaho sa office, I wanna extend more, I wanna work more, I wanna sit more. Right? Wala naman siguro, no? Most of us. Or if you are working abroad, again, kung ganun yung scenario mo, wala naman din nga sigurong gustong babalik pa sa abroad or doing something na talagang most likely dito na lang sa Pilipinas probably spend yung the rest of his life, no? Especially kung terminal nga yung disease. And I think, no, it put into perspective, no, even yung sa trading natin, I think kapag ganun na kalaki yung contrast ng sitwasyon, wala namang gusto magsasabi, teka, chuchupit muna ako. Teka muna, magde-day trade muna ako. I think, magandang perspective to sa buhay natin na, bagamat we're here to earn money, to provide for our families, to pay off yung mga mortgages natin, and then yung mga kung ano-ano pang bagay, no? I think, dapat nating isipin na, all of these are temporary. So, kumbaga sa ano, put things into perspective. Alright? So, mong ipagpalit yung health mo sa money na ma-earn mo. And as we all know, no, marami pang bagay yung mas importante aside from the money. No? So, I think coming from my experience as well, I think medyo may edad na rin ako and I have the right para magsalitaan yan. Especially, no, I do believe na marami, most of my viewers are young professionals, probably starting out sa kanilang mga careers. And I think this is a good time to reflect, no? And sa mga buhay natin, and probably digest. Pag-isipan mabuti, ba't kaya sinasabi nito yung ganyan? Bakit kaya ganun? So, I think it is very, very important that you read the Bible because there are so many things na talaga, kumbaga, sa ano, dito mo malalaman. No? Make it to the point, no? At least, bago mo maubos yung remaining days of your life, to probably make it a goal na basahin yung Bible because there are so many truths that you are here na sana I should have known much earlier and I could have avoided, no? And right now, no? Hindi ako magsasawa sa inyo na read the Bible, right? Nandito na lahat. And don't take my word of it. Basahin mo sa sarili mo. And I think that's a good goal, no? And again, right, we're going to start yung ating market recap. And anything that I would say at this point in time, it is just a mere probability, no? No one really knows kung ano yung mangyayari sa market. We're just here to try to stock yung ating mga opportunities or yung ating probabilities. Alright, so again, take responsibility, no? Number one rule ng recap, take responsibility of your trades. And wala kang sisisihin, no? Kumbaga sa sarili mo, no? Kung natatalo ka ngayon, wala kang ibang sisisihin kung hindi ngayon. And do not take na sana sabi mo sana laging bull market na lang. No, it will not be that way, no? Meron tayong low and highs ng market. And ganun talaga, no? So do not wish, no, na it was easy. And tulad nga ng sinasabi ko, ang dapat mong maging goal is you were better, no? Do not wish it was easy. Dapat ang maging goal mo, you were better, no, sa inyong pag-trade, no? Again, alright, so we're going to start. PSEI lost 159 points for the week. We're closing at 7,583 points. And this is a big back-to-back losses, no, for the PSEI. I think sana naman na tumigil na yung bleeding the market. For the last 2 weeks, we dropped 384 points. Biggest 2 week so far, no? So we're really hopeful na sana magano reverse yung market, but if not, I think we're a big trouble. And from what we're seeing, medyo kumbaga sa ano, delikado yung market. And from now on, I think it's a good idea to lessen your position sa index names, alright? Those 30 names, medyo iwas muna ng konti. Or if you are really, really bullish on something, probably medyo maliit lang muna exposure mo, no? I think that is a general advice na may bibigay ko sa inyo ngayon. Medyo delikado yung market, no? I was really hoping na makaka-recover, but I think this is the biggest 2 week drop na nakita ko for 2019, no? To put things into perspective. Alright, so again, if we're going to look at the charts ng PSEI, so we're here, no? Medyo nag-reverse ng Friday. That's a good thing. We're gonna take it as a good news. But it's not yet convincing, no? I think for now, we could at least hope on the positive side, at least kahit sana mga 7-5 mag-consolidate, yun yung parang ideal natin sana, no? And if it breaks down once more, no? Breakdown, another breakdown, 7250 to 73 area na yung babagsakan natin, no? And anything beyond that, pag bumagsak pa rin doon dito sa area na to, I think we're a big trouble. We might probably see na yung tinatawag nating 69 level, no, way back 2018. I think for the second third quarter of the nakita natin yung level na. Hopefully wag naman sana, no, because currently, right now, parang na-reset lang lahat tayo, no, for 2019. Mapapansin nyo, parang binigay lang lahat ng index yung gain niya for the full duration ng 2019. No? We're back at zero, square one. And hopefully, hindi naman ganun yung nangyari sa inyong profit. No? Pinaghirapan nyo, tapos binalik mo lang din. And kung ganun man yung nangyari, and take it as a lesson, no? So, talagang ganun. You're here for the long term. Hindi yung parang kumbaga sa ano. Hindi mo matatimingan din talaga lahat yan. Alright? So, you're gonna miss. You're gonna miss, no? And you're not be able to anticipate Marami, no? Especially if you're starting out. Ganun talaga, huwag ka lang mapikon. Alright, you're here for the long term. Aim for longevity muna. Alright, longevity and kumbaga sa ano, huwag muna yung puro profit, puro mga quick na mga chupit dyan. Aim for longevity, no? Kung gaano ka katagal, tatagal sa market, no? Especially if you're starting out. Tandaan mo, marami yung nalalagas in their first 6 months, especially 1 year, 2 years, marami na nalalagas, no? And if you just stay long enough in the game, much better chance na talagang you will find your niche and you will find your setups, you will find your probably yung mga strong points mo sa market, no? So ganun talaga, huwag kang mapipikon. That's the way the market goes. All right so next on our watch list, of course meron naman tayo lagi, no? Move of the week, this is Makai Holdings. And it's very, no, Tuesday, no, afternoon election day, Monday, we have a surge, no? I was really interested kung ano kaya itong ano to, big candle na to, 28.5, but being the market is now going, medyo kumbaga sa ano, I'll be more than hesitant, no? If you are going to play this for the next week, which I think will probably have a quick profit dito sa Makai, medyo lita mo lang, no? I think Doji ngayon, this is a neutral position, maganda, nasa support. I think there's a good chance na pwedeng mag-reverse ng konti ito for a quick swing. But other than that, very light, no? Especially dito sa Makai na to. We don't know yet kung ano yung nangyayari, but this is a good volume, no? Almost quarter of a billion yan. Hindi rin basta-basta yan, so I think you have to check and see muna yung price action, no? Especially for the week, if mag-stabilize siya dyan sa around area na yan, 950 to 10, I think this is a good chance, no? Na may play dito sa Makai. Medyo, kumbaga sa ano, they're shaking out, no? Yung mga momentum riders for the last 3 days, medyo pababa yan. They are shaking out. But put this on your watch list, no? Tignan nyo rin, if the market starts strong Monday, Tuesday, there might be a play, no, para dito sa Makai na to. And hopefully you will be able to trade itong Makai. And kinakailangan bantayan nyo lang to kasi napaka-volatile din ang kalawan nito. Uubusin ka nito. Alright, that's it for Makai. I think there's a good chance and probability na mayroong play dito for the next week with the way yung volume niyan. But be very light, no? At least be defensive then. If you don't have the time para i-monitor to the whole day or the whole week, don't, no? Marami pang ibang probable place na pwede sa'yo. So that's our take for Makai Holdings. Makai, I don't know kung ano nito. Alright, so ating for the sentiment. Alright, so ang ating rating is number 4. There's not so good, no? Tulad na sinasabi ko sa inyo, I'm finally turning bearish as well. Because of the looming US-China trade war, no? And ano ba yung US-China trade war? So, I think most of our gurus, if not, medyo, kumbaga sa ano, medyo puro technical analysis yung inaano nila, no? I think this is a good chance na probably catch up, no? How you trade around the news, especially pag mga ganitong sitwasyon. Alright, US, ang stance ng US... Alright, we're gonna bargain sa China. We're going to put some restriction, no, sa Chinese goods. So from 10%, naging 25% yung tariffs, and that tariff increase would be passed on to consumers. And syempre, pag tumataas yung presyo ng isang bagay, especially mga consumers tend to stay away from that, no. So, ang interpretation, once na tumaas yung prices, babagsak din yung market or hihina yung market, no? Same thing sa China. I think from 10% din, sinabayan din. Ni-raise nila yung mga US goods, no? From 10 to 25% din yung tariffs na in-increase, no? So, ang stance ng US, maganda yung market economy namin. We're expanding, I think, 3 to 4% last year yung itinaas ng US market. In China, on the other hand, pababa naman sila, no? So, we're currently seeing na yung Chinese market is starting to slow down, no? Kaya nga inumpisa nila yung Belt and Road Initiative, no? Because yung growth internally hindi na nila masustain, and kinakailangan na lang i-invest yung pera nila sa ibang bansa, no? And kaya nagiging ganun na yung sitwasyon ng China, no? So ang stance naman ng China, of course, we're gonna weather the storm. 2020, magkakaroon ng US election, kinakailangan nilang magpakitang gilas, of course, si Trump. Gusto nilang iniipit nila, eh, no? So I think next year would be the US election. And ang iniisip nila, Trump would give in sa tariff war. And US naman, they are really, really hoping na this is their own, this is the time period na talagang pwede nilang labanan yung economy ng China, no? Economy-wise. Dumalaki kami, medyo nanghihina kayo internally. This is the probably chance na parang, kumbaga sa ano, makipag-negotiate sila, no? With the trade war, no? So, ang stance naman ng US, we're the buyers, kayo yung seller, yung Chinese, and of course, customers always right mentality, no? And of course, mas malaki naman yung binibili ng US compare sa China. So, I think, sana, no, nakuha nyo yung sinasabi ko sa inyo. And ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo, no, na dapat hindi kayo puro sa charts or sa anong kinakailangan, alam niyo yung ano, yung much much higher influence, no, kung bakit ganito nangyayari. And of course sa atin, we're very very affected, no, especially dun sa mga short term na mga news na yan, no. But if this goes on, no, if this goes on, I think for 2020 ganito pa rin, wala silang magiging deal. I think, alam mo, medyo may nakikita akong on the positive side, baka yung mga ibang US companies or even yung mga Chinese investment, baka ma-divert sa atin, no? Especially geographically, malapit tayo. And let's now check and see, no? And this is yet to be tawag dito. Hindi pa natin alam kung ganyan ngayon magpe-play out, because baka in the next coming months, 1 month, 2 months from now, magkaroon sila ng trade deal and all will resume, no? Sa kanilang dating sitwasyon. Again, on the positive note, we're currently seeing yung M&A, no? M&A team stocks. So, what do I mean yung M&A and even yung buyout, no? Mergers and acquisitions. You recently see yung whole team, di ba? Right? So, may Penn, we have Poppy, alright, marami pang iba, even yung GSMI, yan yung mga M&A team stocks, yan yung parang, kumbaga, yung pinapaboran ng market ngayon, no? Yun yung tema ng market ngayon. And right now, no, what we're seeing sa whole SIM, right now, no, we're seeing a blow off, no, currently, no, kung mayroon ka pang whole SIM or you have a large chunk ng whole SIM, probably it's a time to at least, no, take your profit, no. This is a classic blow off. Makikita mo the highest volume, and then makikita mo yung parang excitement build up, biglang tumaas na. And then he was not able to penetrate yung 16 area. So again, I'm not saying that this is the top, but there's a likely chance, no, na it might go down itong whole SIM, no. And play it defensively, no. Huwag ka masyadong umasa na yun, itataas pa ng talagang sobra-sobra, no. And if we see, no, for example, kinakailangan mag-consolidate muna siya rito na mahaba, no, sa 14-14-50 area bago natin makita na probably meron pang chance na tumaas itong old SIM. So again, we all know yung tulad nga na sinabi ko sa inyo kanina na team, we have yung M&A, no, mergers and acquisition, probably yung I think the buyer is Eagle Cement, and they are really really looking forward for a deal, no, itong sa old SIM, no. And one of the stocks na beneficiary ng old SIM, hindi naman siya kasama dun sa ano na yon, sa deal na yon, but CHP, no, nadadala siya because they are both cement stocks, no. We're seeing good price action at this moment, triple top, tama-tama lang naman, nag-resist siya dun sa area na yon, dito sa 280-290 area. And right now, no, we just want to see at least for the moment mag-consolidate itong CHP dito sa area na to, no, at least sa 250-260 area, itong green zone na to. Consolidate muna siya diyan bago niya mabreak tong triple top na to, no. So medyo proving to be a good ano to, eh, resistance para sa CHP, no? I think itong drop na to, if you all remember it right, this was announced, no? Yung stock, no? Yung pararamihin nila yung shares for additional na fondo, no? Biglang bumaba and then slowly it crept in, no? Tumaas na tumaas itong CHP. And right now, no? At least yung gusto natin makita sa kanya, bumaba muna or mag-consolidate sa area na yun, sa green zone. And ang maganda naman dito, fundamentally speaking, meron siyang overriding team din, no? Of course, if you remember it right, yung import for cement products, they are going to be benefiting, no? Itong CHP. And I think it's being, tawag dito, confirmed by the price action. Alright, so right now, if you don't have CHP, let's try to see muna, no, kung mag-consolidate na dun siya sa green area before moving, no, to, para i-break niya yung 280-290, no. I think this is one of the active, no, if not. Marami rin ipit na institution dito, eh, dito sa area na to. So, they'll try to break that area, no, as much as possible. And, of course, yung team niya, fundamental news niya. So, again, alright, for the past 2 weeks, the market has been dropping like crazy. And maganda rin naman dito sa GSMI, no? Currently, nasa 39.7 na rin siya. Maganda naman nangyari sa GSMI. Alright, classic, no? Papansin nyo, it finally did break and if big volume, no? And it was able to negate yung bearish resistance dito sa 35 area. Right now, no? It's currently 39.7 and this is something to do with the SMC, no? Yung mother company niya. We all know kung ano yung mga nangyayari ngayon dyan with the fine-tuning ng business nila. I think it's gonna benefit, no? Yung GSMI as confirmed by the price action. But right now, we're currently seeing a bearish divergence, no? Pababa yung volume but yung price tumataas, no? You might want to be patient muna, no, sa GSMI kung gusto mong pasukin talaga to. Be patient for the proper entry. And just put this on your watch list, no. I think this is one of the few stocks na talagang tumaas habang yung markets bumababa. Take note of that, right? Ganun na ganun din natin nahuli yung SLI dati, di ba? Bumababa yung market, but yung SLI, look at SLI daw, no? Matagal na natin naispatan yun, di ba? Ganun din yung analysis natin, no? Bumababa yung market, sila tumataas. That's going to be one of the things na dapat mong na-obserbahan, no? So, wait for the proper entry sa GSMI kung saan medyo yung candles natin is hindi na ganun ka-volatile, no? And next on our watch list would be SSI. Alright, SSI medyo hirap na rin sa 330-345 area, no? We're currently seeing noise dito sa area na to. And baga sa ano, if you have defending on your position, di ba? Yung nakasulat dito. You might want to check and see, no, for the dips, no? Probably siguro around 293 area, magandang area na 'yan. And we're currently seeing good and resistance, no? And medyo hesitation siya, no? 3.25 to 344 area, no? But why are we going to look on this, no? Because yung fundamental news naman niya, maganda, no? The company is starting to pile up good earnings. SSI, di ba? Right? And I think this is one of the reasons kung ba't din tumaas to ng matindi. No? Hope you were able to catch itong SSI, no? Itong dip na to. Di ba? Ang maganda rin naman kasi sa market, kahit hindi mo naman siya mahuli on the actual breakout, eh. Maghihintay ka ng dip, you know, 2 days na to. I was really patient, no? Nung nag-confirm, hindi na ako nag-hesitate na mag-buy. I was able to swing this, no? Pag ganun, sa area na yan. And, huwag ka rin naman na aasa na talaga matatsyempo mo lagi yung pinakatoktok mabibenta mo. Huwag ganun. Right? Huwag masanayin sa sarili mo na dapat maibenta mo sa toktok. Ang dapat mong i-develop yung anticipation, di ba? Alright, so that is our take for SSI Group. We're going to I think one of the few reversals na right now, no? Maganda yung sineset up niya, no? I think this has been heavily battered, no? Itong Sirtrek. But right now, no? Right now, we're really, really seeing a small amount of buyers dito. And as confirmed, the price action, medyo nagre-reverse na siya, no? What do we do with Sirtrek? Of course, medyo, kumbaga sa ano, matindi pa rin yung noise mo dyan, eh. Makikita mo yung ranges niya, lalaki pa rin. But with the way the price is going, na kailan umahanap ka na ng magandang entry dito, no? If you really believe dito sa Sirtrek, especially they are developing some products right now na I think that it will have a market traction, no? Itong Sirtrek. Alright, so I think this is a good candidate for a quick reversal, no? So, ma-target prices natin for the meantime probably 29, around 29, no? Or below 30. And yung next target natin is around 31 area, no? So, this for a quick, pwede, no? Pwede. I'm currently seeing buyers, no? I'm seeing demand at this area. And, parang, kumbaga sa, ano, medyo exhausted na yung mga tao, no? And, put this on your watch list, Sir Trek. I think may maganda tayong position dito na pwedeng i-play. And, again, one of the heavily battered stocks din. And I think this is the point in time na parang kumbaga sa ano, nagre-reverse na, no? There's a reversal of a sentiment. Right, for MRSGI. And we are also seeing, no? Yung classic na two-tower setup. And, papansin nyo, this is the two biggest volume of the whole, I think, for the, at least, November last year, no? And medyo exhausted na, medyo pagod na yung taong kabibenta, kaka-cut loss. And right now, we're also seeing yung ating insider buyers as well, no? Na disclose na din naman yan. At least we're hoping for a quick turnaround, at least sa 310 area, no? Kung suswertihin tayo, or if mag-play out yung play na to, probably dun tayo sa area na yun mag-bebenta, no? So, MRSGI, if you are new to this reversal, probably you're sawang-sawa ka na marinig yung ating mga gurus na they are really telling you to avoid falling knife. Totoo din naman yun, no? If you are really new, huwag kang bumili ng mga ganito. But if you're well-experienced and you have yung proper risk management, no, magandang opportunity, no, itong time of the market para aralin itong mga ganitong setup or yung mga ganitong stocks, no. So again, right now, no, it is looking really for a reversal, no. So now I think last but not the least, yung Poppy. All right, this is flying under the radar for quite some time. I was not able to monitor din tong Poppy, and it finally did break, no? From a classic cup and handle, no? Diba? This is the cup. This is the handle. It finally did break out with volume, alright? Yun yung mas importante. Alright, so, depending on the development of the market, no? Monday, Tuesday, or even for the whole week, kung malakas yung market, there will be a follow-through dito sa Poppy. So, yung 331 na yan, mura pa yan. But if not, if you are going to play it defensively, at least wait for a retest, no? Kung bibili ka, at least dun sa 306, pinakamalapit sana. Or if not, dun sa range ng 324, no? 306, 324 area, no? Again, Poppy, if you're not familiar, it will be probably acquired. If not, no, na-acquire na ng Ayala, and they're going to transform this Poppy stocks to logistics, no? And right now, no, news, price confirmation, we have the volume. I do not think na meron pang ibang mas gaganda pa sa setup ng Poppy right now, no, currently sa market. But play it defensively, no, hindi natin alam because, again, yung trade war is really heavy, no? And naapektuhan tayo niyan, no? Whether we like it or not, apektado tayo ng trade war. And with that, I hope you're able to gain something, no, sa aking PSEI recap. And please like or subscribe if you have not yet subscribed as well. And again, thank you for tuning in, and thank you for your time, and see you next week. And again, take your profit, and dapat steadily increasing yung inyong pera, no? Again, maraming salamat sa panonood.